was the movie star who transformed Hollywood, challenging prejudices with charm and passion, winning over audiences with a searing charisma that leapt from the screen.
My skin is black.
My skin is black.
No, her skin is white.
But as a child, Sidney Poitier never dreamed of fame, growing up in the Bahamas in a family of humble tomato farmers.
I knew we had no money. Still, I was taught that I was someone.
When he moved to the US as a teenager, he fell into his future profession by pure chance.
I was looking for a dishwashing job, and something caught my eye. It said, actors wanted.
And those two words changed the course of his life forever, leading him to a stage career which caught the eye of Hollywood.
The reaction hasn't set in yet. Like a woman who's just had a baby, I won't believe it until I see it.
At a time when movie leads were uniformly white, Poitier was thrust into the role of the leading man, where he repeatedly broke ground, most notably for his performance in Lilies of the Field.
How about thanking me too, eh?
No. I thank him. You couldn't help yourself.
That role earned him an Oscar.
The winner is Sidney Poitier.
Making him the first ever black American man to win Best Actor.
All I can say is a very special thank you.
But his banner moment came in 1967, the year that saw three of his best-known works released, beginning with the English film To Sir With Love.
I think I'd better go and put it away.
Then came In the Heat of the Night, the fiery cop drama in which he played a detective trying to solve a murder in America's Deep South.
Virgil, that's a funny name for a boy that comes from Philadelphia. What do they call you up there?
They call me Mr. Tibbs.
And the taboo of interracial marriage was broken in the controversial Guess Who's Coming to Dinner.
Mrs. Drayton, I'm medically qualified, so I hope you wouldn't think it presumptuous if I say you ought to sit down before you fall down, I mean.
He thinks you're gonna faint because he's a Negro.
But his role as a beacon of progress was a heavy one to bear, and he soon grew weary of reporters asking the same questions of race over and over.
If you sit here and ask me such one-dimensional questions, I am an awful lot of things, so I wish you would pay me the respect due and not simply ask me about those things.
Poitier took his career at his own pace, at one stage stepping away from acting for a decade while he directed movies, before eventually returning to the big screen.
There isn't a government on this planet that wouldn't kill us all for that thing.
Poitier not only entertained, but enlightened, shifting attitudes, broadening hearts, revealing the power of the silver screen to bring us closer together.
In 2009, he was awarded the USA's highest civilian honor by Barack Obama, who is now among the many paying tribute to the star.
He was a movie star when we were only being portrayed as slaves and criminals, and he did it with grace and he did it with artistry.
Poitier died in his home at the age of 94.
As a young man, when I first got to know the world and where I was situated in it, I developed a strong belief that the time would change. Now it is clear that I am changed by time. I never expected that.